The Mini is finally here, and mine is also finally here. I never recommend ordering online through Apple because I waited weeks for this thing to get shipped, and I could have stopped at any store during any of those weeks and picked one up, but I withheld. If you haven't seen my HomePod 2 years later video, go check that out in the video description. But today we're going to be looking at the successor to the HomePod Mini. I honestly thought it was a 50-50 toss-up between Apple either completely scrapping the HomePod name altogether or creating a second generation. Apple's sales were pretty good on the HomePod, and the smart home speaker business continues to boom with Amazon and Google, so it makes sense for Apple to stay in the game. The unboxing experience is fun and minimal as usual, and I'm seeing Apple as being more environmentally friendly by using only paper and cardboard. I didn't encounter any plastic whatsoever. Pretty cool. Included in the box is a white USB-C 20-watt power adapter, some paperwork, and an Apple sticker. I'm a big fan of the black braided cable. I was extremely surprised by how light the HomePod Mini is. At just 345 grams, or 0.76 pounds, I was expecting it to have more weight. But it's actually still double the weight of the Google Home Mini. Setup is easy. Just plug it in, and it boots up automatically. Pair it with your Apple device simply by having it in proximity of your Mini. Follow the steps, and you're all set in around just a minute. Let's test out the sound.
Hey Siri, play me some Megan Thee Stallion.
Megan Thee Stallion now playing.
Hey Siri, stop. I expected a better song.
Oh yeah, I just wanna see you smile. Don't cry. Even though it means I gotta let you go. Depending on you, gotta learn to be alone.
Sound quality is great and extremely clear. Nowhere near as much bass and thump as the original HomePod though, but that's to be expected because of the size. But this little guy packs a punch. More clear than the UE Boom in my opinion, but obviously not portable like the UE Boom. At just 99 bucks, this thing is a steal. If you're knees deep in the Apple ecosystem, you like good quality sound, and you're content with the fact that both Alexa and the Google Assistant are still better smart home assistants than Siri. But it's hard to beat the continuity this has with other Apple devices, its sleek design, reasonable price, ease of use, and most importantly, its superb sound quality.
Hey Siri, tell me a funny joke.
Did you hear about the explosion at the cheese factory? All that was left was debris.
Oh my God, no.